Good morning. Today we are going to experimentally determine the position, velocity, and acceleration as a function of time graphs for a sliding street hockey puck.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Let's start with a graph of position as a function of time. To be clear, the black squares are the experimentally observed data, and the blue curve is a best-fit curve that best approximates and interpolates the data. Again, black squares are observed data, and blue curve is a best-fit curve. Considering this is the graph of position as a function of time for the sliding puck, Bobby, what should the graph of velocity as a function of time look like?
We know velocity is the slope of the position as a function of time graph, and the initial slope of the line is negative, so the initial velocity is negative.
And as time increases, the slope of the line gets closer and closer to zero, so the velocity should get closer to zero.
So the velocity as a function of time graph starts out negative and then increases at a constant rate to zero.
Correct. The velocity starts out negative. And then as time goes by, that velocity increases in value until it approaches a value of zero. Let's see if this matches what we get experimentally. Why is the velocity of the puck negative?
Because the puck is moving to the left.
Correct. And Bo, why is the slope of the velocity as a function of time graph constant?
Because the slope of a velocity versus time graph is acceleration, and the puck is in uniformly accelerated motion.
Very nice. And therefore, Bo, what should the graph of acceleration as a function of time look like?
Well, if the acceleration is constant, then the slope of the acceleration versus time graph should be zero, so it's a horizontal line.
Should it be above or below the time axis?
Above, because the puck is slowing down, and therefore its acceleration is opposite the direction of the puck's velocity. The puck's velocity is negative and to the left, so its acceleration is to the right and positive.
Yes. Because the acceleration is both constant and positive, the acceleration as a function of time graph should have a horizontal line with a positive value. Again, the puck should be experiencing uniformly accelerated motion, or UAM. Let's see if it is. Well, it turns out the acceleration isn't quite constant. We can determine an average value for the acceleration and approximate this as uniformly accelerated motion. However, it's not quite UAM. The reason for that is the force of friction, which is causing the acceleration of the puck, isn't quite constant. We can model this motion as UAM pretty well using the average acceleration value. However, it is important to understand that that is an approximation. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.